It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, Chief Investment Officer at Payne Capital Management. And after getting off to a blistering start in 2018, markets reversed course this week with the largest weekly fall in 2 years. Now, many pundits believe the week's decline is simply an overdue pullback, exacerbated by fears of rising inflation, a move higher in interest rates, and a crash in investment products where hedge funds made huge bets on low volatility. Not a good decision with high volatility right now. Well, this may simply be a repricing of financial assets to the new reality of increasing wages and interest rates. See, corporations will have to pay more in salaries for the same amount of work and issue new corporate debt at higher rates, increasing their cost of borrowing. So simply a repricing of financial assets, not a fundamental shift. See, earnings in the U.S. continue to beat analyst expectations and are up nearly 15% from the same period a year ago, highest growth rate since the third quarter of 2011. We also saw, more importantly, revenue growth, and that's also the highest since the third quarter of 2011. See, the bottom line is the markets are inherently volatile. As investors, we don't mind upside volatility or the new record highs we experienced over the last 9 years. And when the normal correction or downside volatility that we all expected finally arrives, well, we tend to flip out because we're all average, normal human beings. And downside volatility is just a fancy Wall Street term for losses. And no one, and I mean no one, likes losses. So over the past 20 years, there's been 10 corrections in the S&P 500, including the current one. And on average, it takes about 4 months to recover the losses. Just reminds us that every dip in history has been temporary and the ups inevitable. You know, I think John Bogle says it best. The stock market is a giant distraction to the business of investing. Focusing on the day-to-day is a really good way to lose sight of the long-term trends or why you're investing in the first place.